Section 3.4, the Euclidean algorithm. Before we discuss section 3.4, let me go back to section 3.3. Please take a look at this example. Over here, we want to find the greatest common divisor of 52 and 272. One way to find the greatest common divisor is to list all divisors of 52, then all divisors of 272, and then find the biggest common divisor. But of course, this is a very laborious process. What we see over here is a much faster way of finding the greatest common divisor. We use the division algorithm. We divide 272 by 52 and find the remainder. Then, by this property, we get rid of this component, done. Then again, we apply the division algorithm to divide 52 by 12 and find the remainder. We get rid of this, done. And then the result falls. It's exactly what we do in section 3.4. Please take a look at theorem 1 that we call Euclidean algorithm. Suppose A and B are integers such that A is greater or equal to B and B is greater than 0. Theorem 1 says that there is an algorithm that finds the greatest common divisor of A and B. In order to show you this algorithm that we actually previewed here, we need the following lemma. Suppose A, B, Q, R are integers and A is equal to BQ plus R. Then, the greatest common divisor of AB, which is over here, is equal to the greatest common divisor of BR, which is over here. This is exactly what we did over here. The greatest common divisor of 52 and 272 is equal to the greatest common divisor of 52, which is over here, and the remainder. So, the proof is pretty straightforward. Step 1, replace A by this expression, done. After that, use Theorem 1, Part 2. By Theorem 1, Part 2, this is indeed equal to the greatest common divisor of BR. Done. And now, let us discuss the algorithm that finds the greatest common divisor of A and B. Here is the algorithm. We apply the division algorithm repeatedly. Step 1. Let us denote A by R0 and B by R1. By division algorithm, we have this where R2, which is over here, is greater or equal to 0 and strictly lesser than R1. Here's what we do next. We use the lemma. The greatest common divisor of A and B is equal to the greatest common divisor of B and R2. Next, by the division algorithm, R1, which is over here, is R2, which is over here, times Q2 plus R3, where R3 is greater or equal to zero and lesser than R2. And again, by this, thanks to the lemma, the greatest common divisor of these two numbers, which is over here, is equal to the greatest common divisor of these two numbers, which is over here. Next, by the division algorithm, R2, which is over here, is equal to R3, which is over here, times Q3 plus R4, where R4 is greater or equal to zero and lesser than R3. Thanks to this and the lemma above, the greatest common divisor of these two numbers, which is over here, is equal to the greatest common divisor of these two numbers, which is over here. And so on, the greatest common divisor of Rn minus 3, Rn minus 2, is the greatest common divisor of Rn minus 2, Rn minus 1. Then the greatest common divisor of these two numbers is equal to the greatest common divisor of these two numbers. Lastly, note that at some point, the remainder becomes zero. Here is why. Note that all these R's are non-negative. On the other hand, the sequence of these R's, thanks to this, is strictly decreasing. This means that at some point, the remainder will be zero. So n is a number such that the remainder here is equal to zero. Rn minus 1 is equal to RnQn plus 0. From this, it follows that the greatest common divisor of Rn minus 1 and Rn, which is over here, is equal to the greatest common divisor of Rn and 0. But the greatest common divisor of Rn and 0 is Rn. Conclusion, this is equal to Rn. And now, let us put pieces together. The greatest common divisor of R0, R1, which is over here, is equal to the greatest common divisor of AB, because R0 is A. Thanks to this. And R1 is B, thanks to this. This is equal to this, it's over here. This is equal to this, it's over here, and so on. This is equal to this, it's over here, which is equal to Rn. Conclusion. The greatest common divisor of A and B is equal to Rn, which is the last non-zero remainder. Any questions here?
How does, starting at the first line, how does the greatest common divisor of R0 and R1 equal the greatest common divisor of R1 and R2?
Okay, very good question. Your question is, why this is equal to this?
Yes.
Please take a look at this lemma. Note that R0 which is over here, is equal to R1 Q1 plus R2. We have same situation is here. We start from this, and this number is dQ plus R. This lemma says that since A is dQ plus R, this is equal to the greatest common divisor of BR. Similarly here, since R0 is equal to this, the greatest common divisor of R0, R1 is equal to the greatest common divisor of R1, R2. We jump from here to here by the lemma because R0 is this.
Okay, I see it. Thanks.
Any other questions?
Professor, I had a question.
Yes?
Is it efficient to use Euclid's algorithm to check for prime numbers?
Well, I would say the answer is no. How would you do that?
Oh, sorry. So I start with one number, but I prove that the GCD of it and all numbers below it is equal to one.
So you have n number, and then in order to check if this number is prime, you want to consider the greatest common divisor of this number and all previous numbers. This algorithm is way too long.
Okay.
So one way to show that a number is prime is to use theorem 2. Theorem 2 says the following. In order to check whether or not a given integer n is prime, we divide this number n by all prime that do not exceed square root of n. If n is not divisible by any of these prime numbers, n is prime. For example, in order to show that 101 is prime, it is enough to divide 101 by all prime numbers that do not exceed square root of 101, which means by prime numbers 2, 3, 5, and 7 only. We divide 101 by 2, we divide 101 by 3, we divide 101 by 5, and by 7.
Yeah, sorry, my question was more pertaining to like if we had a very big N such that we didn't know if the like, or we didn't have a easily generated list of prime numbers below N or square root of N.
Well, it's a good point. Basically, you can divide N by all numbers that do not exceed square root of N. Even in this case, this approach is better than yours. Instead of considering all greatest common divisors, we just divide n by each integer that does not exceed square root of n. This is not an optimal algorithm, but this is better than you suggested.
Oh, okay, I see. Thank you.
Other questions here?
Is there anything significant about the n value in the subscript?
Are you talking about this?
Yes.
So, it's another good question. Once again, n is such a subscript that the corresponding remainder is equal to zero. So, the difference between this and this is the following. We stop when the remainder is equal to zero.
Okay.
For example, if b is a divisor of A, we stop immediately. We'll get the following. A is equal to B times Q1 plus zero. And we stop.
Okay, that makes sense. Thank you.
By the way, if R2 is equal to zero, then the greatest common divisor of A and B is equal to B, because A is divisible by B. Now, examples. By the way, please take a look at this remark. One can show that if the Euclidean algorithm requires n steps, for the pair A, B, then the number of steps does not exceed 5 times logarithm base 10 of B. So the algorithm is pretty fast. Examples. Find the greatest common divisor of 252 and 198. Step 1. By the division algorithm, 252 is 198 times 1 plus 54. So, in order to come up with this, we just divide this by this and find the remainder. Next, divide 198 by the remainder and find next remainder, 36. Divide 54, this 54, by 36 and find the remainder. And lastly, divide 36 by 18. Since the remainder is 0, we stop. Conclusion, the greatest common divisor of these two numbers, which is over here, is equal to 18. It's here. Similarly, in order to find the greatest common divisor of these two numbers, divide 326 by 78, find the remainder, then divide 78 by 14, find the remainder, divide 14 by 8, find the remainder, divide 8 by 6, find the remainder, and lastly, 6 is an integer multiple of 2. The remainder is 0. We stop. Conclusion. The greatest common divisor of these two numbers is this, 2. Lastly, please take a look at these very large numbers. But the process is relatively short. First, we divide this by this and find the remainder. Then we divide this by this and find the remainder, and so on. We stop when the remainder is 0. Once the remainder is 0, the greatest common divisor of these two numbers is this number, which is 7.